Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Meadow View Church, 768 Summit Road here in Eden, North Carolina. Welcome to our Veterans Service Sunday. I know Veterans Day is actually tomorrow, but this is the closest we could get to it. So we're having a very patriotic service today. But again, thank you for taking your time and effort, energy to be with us today. For our announcements, notice who's not here, reach out to them, please. Bingo, we've got three more Tuesday nights in this month, and we're meeting at 5 o'clock just this month. And of course, we stop for January, February, March, and we start back in April. So we've got three more times, and we've doubled the amount of money that we collected last year for the Rockingham Bible Council, which pays for Bible teachers in our schools, and I'll give you an update on that after our final meeting. We need bingo prizes for the nursing home, canned foods for the food pantry. We probably aren't doing shoe boxes. If anybody wants to do a shoe box, that's fine. I'll be glad to carry it to First Presbyterian Church. Next Sunday is the last day that I can accept that because I'll need to go and see them the following day. But we have thought about helping Western North Carolina in one of three ways. First of all, Samaritan's Purse Relief, and this specifically is a donation. Any of these three things, you write your donation to Meadow View Church, you get credit for it, and then Diane will actually write one check for any of these three groups. And again, the first one is Samaritan's Purse. It will actually go to Western North Carolina. Shoeboxes all have to go overseas. They don't go in the United States. God's Pit Crew is another possibility out of Danville that helps in the mountains. And then the third one is High Country Caregivers, which helps kids that are living with grandmas or kids that have been taken out of their homes. If you write a check, make sure you put on the notation line what you want it to go towards, one of those three things, or we have love offerings in the back, and Diane needs that today if you would like to contribute. Friends helping friends. That's wonderful. Janice, tell us.
Friends helping friends has turned out wonderful. Basically, we have collected one corner of my whole living room full of food. It's a big pot. Gigantic pot. We also have $1,800, approximately, give or take. We haven't counted everything up that we are going and purchasing. We've already talked to someone by writing. Stokesdale is willing to sell us canned food for just a fraction over the cost to purchase. And I will have more details of how everything we buy, number of cans,
wonderful.
I want to thank everybody for everything that you did. I can't say thank you enough.
Thank you. Thank you for your work and this wonderful effort. We also are collecting items for a homeless shelter this month. And, we'll carry those to them at the end of November. Also, we're collecting this Sunday and next Sunday donations for the Circle of Friends. We normally do that twice a year, and this is the time for that. So think about that also, if you would, please. Do you have other announcements we need to share this morning? Do we have any birthdays? Anniversaries? You should have a sheet that's got our pledges that we'll be doing in a minute. Before we do that, we're going to have our national anthem. If you would stand as you're able to stand for our national anthem, please.
States of America,
and to the republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now our Christian flag. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag, and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one brotherhood uniting all Christians in service and love. And then our pledge to the Bible. Again, attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word, and will make it a lamp unto my feet, a light unto my path, and hide its words in my heart, that I may not sin against God. If you'll remain standing, if you'll turn, everything's in our blue hymn book today. If you'll turn to page 697, America, 697.
Thank you.
you will turn into the Blue Book, page 646, we have our call to worship, 646. It's at the bottom of the page. Of course, your part is the dark print. Let love be genuine and live in harmony. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Outdo one another in showing honor. Be humble and never conceited.
Love is stronger than death, and jealousy is cruel as the grave. Words cannot drown love, and wealth cannot buy it.
Put love above all else. Let Christ's peace rule your hearts. Always be forgiving, as Christ has forgiven you.
Love is not jealous or boastful, arrogant, rude, stubborn, irritable, resentful, possessive. Love is patient and kind.
Do not love in word or speech only. Love also in deed and truth. Receive each other in sincerity. Find mercy and grow old together.
Love rejoices in the right. It bears, believes, hopes, endures all things. For love is faithful and endless.
When the Lord builds the house, the labor is never in vain.
Happy are those who take refuge in God. Those who serve the Lord are redeemed.
Thank you, and you may be seated. Jay-Z, if you would come up, please. Today we're celebrating a special day in the year, and that day is Veterans Day. Now, a veteran is anybody that has served our country, and we're very thankful for, you know, the people that are willing to basically stop their regular lives and you know, go to serve our country to protect us, to protect our freedom, to protect our lives, our safety. They do so many things. I brought today a jacket that belonged to my brother-in-law, Tony Joyce. He was in the Army, and he served two tours of duty in Vietnam. There's an interesting patch there on the side. We looked that up while ago. Part of it is sacrifice, and, you know, the sword is a sword for you know, for fighting for peace, protection, and so forth. Anyway, I appreciate his years of service in the military and everybody else. You know, some people get mixed up when we think about Memorial Day and Veterans Day. Memorial Day is when we honor everybody that has actually died in service. Who lost their lives. Veterans Day, we honor every single person that has ever served in the military. And today is that special, special day. And, you know, think about all the sacrifices that people have done. Some people lost an arm or a leg, and maybe they were blind, or, you know, all kind of things and have to do. Others still sacrificed even if they didn't lose any of their body. In service, they lost time that they would have used some other way. So it's important to remember today, we are thankful for every single person that has served our country in the military, whether it was the Army, the Marines, or the Air Force, the Coast Guard, you know, what unit it might have been. We are thankful. protect our freedoms. Bless them. Thank you, Lord. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for coming up. And here's your little. And there's what the jacket looked like. You couldn't see it when I was holding it forward. So it actually belongs to Nick. He inherited it from his Uncle Tony. Please join with me as we say together the Apostles' Creed. You may stay seated. I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived
by
the
Holy
Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under
Pontius Pilate,
was crucified and buried. The third day he arose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. I'd like to share with you a poem before we do our salute to the troops. This poem was written by Susan Smith, and she says, I'm a published author that loves to use my talents to encourage and inspire. And she said that she wrote this poem to encourage and to honor our U.S. veterans, active and non-active. I wish to thank them in writing this poem to let them know how much they are appreciated for their sacrifice and their time. Men and women who are serving or have served deserve our gratitude today, and that's certainly true. The poem is entitled Memorial Day Poem. To all our veterans, far and near, we thank you for your service for all those years. You sacrificed your time, and some gave your life. You preserved our freedom by willingly paying the price. Many of you were sent overseas. You were wounded in battle with scars and disease. But courageous and brave, you weathered the storm. You face every battle with faith and beyond. We honor you with joy for all that you've done. You stood strong for our country, for our daughters and sons. So no one stands alone. We walk hand in hand. Remember, we are with you. Together we shall stand. We salute you today. Hear what we say. Let our words speak eloquently in this special way. On this day, let us express our thanks and love for the sacrifice you paid. You served in honor for many years and days, and we will never forget how you were strong and brave. So I think that's a wonderful poem that lifts up our people that have served. I'm going to play a CD that has salute to the military. And if you were in the military, if I get to your section, please stand for that particular section. This is Anthony Berger playing. Try again. That was the last CD I had in. a different one.
I didn't think it was that.
Okay, we'll try again. At least you're awake. Absolutely. Thank you. How has God blessed you?
Being able to be here.
Amen.
Amen.
And you're a blessing to me. Martha.
I got a good report from my CT scan this week.
Wonderful. Great news. Okay. Others. Yes.
Thankful for the way my food drive turned out.
Amen. Absolutely. And the people in Western North Carolina will be even more grateful. Absolutely. Anyone else? Okay, thank you. I'm glad that's happening. Anyone else? God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Absolutely. Our next hymn is 696 in the Blue Book. America the Beautiful, 696. Let us stand at your aid. We have many to lift up in prayer today. We want to lift up Tabitha Godwin, our nation, David Moore, those not here today, our schools, James Stevens, Karen Johnson, Country of Ukraine, Dwayne Jeffries, Lorraine Joyce, Kate Price, UNC Rockingham Rehab, Ricky Hall, Cindy Bowling, Joe Bowling, Betty Booth, Michael Gardner, Laura Brown, Simmons family, Jim Seacrest, Christy Swift, all churches, many unspoken requests, Eden Rehab Center, Winona Price, the Thacker family, the Nation of Israel, the Lawson family, Dorian Atham, Jesse Carter, Joe Brown, the Ridney family, Anna Gant, firemen and first responders, Kath and Jim Eanes, Rem Bowling, Jessica Hatcher, Dennis Kendrick, the Dalton family, Mary Young, Rita Vernon, William Carter, Judy Fagg, James Osborne, Donna Gallardo, Calvin and Susan Stultz, Barney McBride, Connie Williams, Sonia Wason, Bonnie O'Dale, Samantha Gardner, Cole Colley, Janice Estes, storm victims and responders, people, and then the fires are getting larger according to what I saw on TV. I certainly need to pray for those people and responders. Josh Taylor, Karen Yarber, Lee Lawson, Frida Scott, his granddaughter, David Yoder, Billy White, and that was Michaela. Good thing her name there for a second, even though it was in front of me. Do we have other updates or additions? Yes.
Doug Carr, my brother, he's in the hospital. He's got some things going on, and they really don't know whether it's his heart or his lungs or what it is. But he's got fluid on him. One of my sisters had called me this morning.
Absolutely. Yeah. Doug Carter. Others? Yes.
A friend of mine, Bill Salt. He's in Baptist Hospital.
And what was the last name again?
Sarva. He has liver cancer.
Okay, thank you. Others? Diane.
Got a text from Kathy yesterday. She said she got her drain out on Tuesday, which was a plus. Her oncologist was pleased when she went for a visit on Friday. He was pleased with the surgery results and how she was progressing, and that he would be referring her to have radiation treatments and more chemo. The chemo is going to be in a pill form, and it's really as ongoing, just a preventative measure. Yeah. So it sounds better than what she was told initially.
Absolutely, thank you.
She said, thank you for the prayers and keep praying.
Absolutely. Others? Let us pause for our meditation and our prayers, please. Lord, you're awesome. You're all powerful, all knowing, ever present, all loving, all forgiving. Thank you for all of your attributes that we can't even comprehend. Lord, be with all that are sick, lift them up, remove their pain, heal their bodies, be with those that are grieving, be with those that are trying to find solutions to various problems in their lives. Lord, we ask that You be with this church. Help us as we continue to grow and serve you in many different ways right here in this community, in the world. Lord, thank you for your holy word. Let it be a light unto us that we might apply it to our lives, that we might be pleasing to you. Lord, thank you for the military, for all that have served throughout the years, that we might have freedoms, that we might have protection, that our lives might be better. Father, just continue to be with us, lead us, and guide us. For we ask this in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. This time I'd like to ask Judy and Janice if they would come forward for our morning offering. Let us stand as you're able for our doxology, please.
From whom all blessings flow. Thank you.
blessings upon these our gifts. Use them for your kingdom, the building of this church. So do you. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Thank you, ladies.
When I fear my faith will fail, Christ will hold me fast. When the tempter would prevail, he will hold me fast. I could never keep my hold through life's tearful path, for my love is often cold. He will hold me fast. He will hold me fast. He will hold me fast, for my Savior, he loves me so. He will hold me fast. Those he saves are his delight. Christ will hold me fast, precious in his holy sight. He will hold me fast. He'll not let my soul be lost. His promises shall last, bought by him at such a cost. He will hold me fast. He will hold me fast. He will hold me fast. For my Savior, he loves me so. He will hold me fast. Christ will hold me fast. Justice has been satisfied. He will hold me fast. Raised to him with endless life. He will hold me fast. Till our faith is turned to sight. When he comes at last, he will hold me fast. He will hold me fast. For my Savior, he loves me so. He will hold me fast. He will hold me fast. He will hold us fast. For my Savior, he loves me so.
Thank you, Nick, for reminding us that we're always in the hands of God. He never leaves us nor forsakes us, and he will always hold us fast. Thank you. For our scripture today, I'd like to read just a couple of verses. This comes from John chapter 15, verses 12 and 13. I'm reading from the King James Version. Again, John chapter 15, beginning with verse 12. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Some of my ideas today come from Michael Church. I appreciate being able to go on the internet and go to many different places and come up with some various ideas that I might not think of. And there's very few original ideas anymore in the world. Somebody's thought of it already somewhere along the way. A number of years ago, my parents did a lot of traveling. They went to all 48 continental United States here in our country. They went to Israel at least three times. Went to Egypt and England and France. And there in France, a long time ago, there was a sign that was posted there in the subway. And next to the sign, there was a couple of seats, and these seats were reserved for ex-service members. You know, that's, I thought, very, very good for the French people to do that. Reserved seats for mutuelles de crevée. Literally, those that are mutilated by war, those that might have lost an arm or a limb or their eyesight. These simple signs were a sobering reminder of the fact that they were all around us in those days, men and women who only a few decades earlier had fought bravely to preserve the world from all of the fascism and communism and all the different things, and we survived, but we survived at a cost. Veterans Day observance has its roots not in the Second World War, as some people might imagine, but it goes all the way back to World War I. In fact, tomorrow we'll celebrate 106 years from the ending of World War I. When the guns fell silent, the Great War had shaken the foundations of the old empires. It had redrawn maps. It seemed like a chapter from the Revelation in the Bible at the end of the world. Peace came at the 11th hour on the 11th day in the 11th month. The timing was symbolic. The 11th hour, the last few minutes of the day. We sometimes still use that expression, the 11th hour, just before all hope is lost. An 11th hour call from the governor may spare a criminal's life. It's not about time. It's about urgency, immediacy, the last chance to stand up against disaster. Oh, that my words might be written down, engraved in stone, says Job in the Bible. Or even on my flesh, though it destroy my skin. His friends had been telling Job to give up hope, to admit that life is futile, to curse God and die. But Job stood up against every single one of them. Despite his miseries, despite all the suffering that he had endured, despite the cross that he bore, Job trusted in something more. He said, I know that my Redeemer lives, I believe, in other words, that beyond the cross and his threat of death lies the empty tomb and his promise of life. Job is a soldier of sorts, not like Samson or David. He doesn't struggle with the Philistines. Instead, he struggles with doubt, fear, anger, despair. And at the 11th hour, in the face of destruction, he stands up for goodness. He stands up for faith. You can almost hear the trumpet blow as he gives the battle cry, "I know that my Redeemer lives. And as I stand up now, so at the last day, he too will stand beside me." Again, just like Nick was saying, you know, God stands fast with us. He stood fast with Job. In Roman times, a church member might be called a Miles Christi, a soldier of Christ. The opposite was a Pagamus, a pagan, which meant a country person, not because the Roman army was slain for a civilian. So to be a Christian meant to join up, to enlist. But you didn't have to be young and fit. You could be old, bent over, blind, crippled. A child or even an infant, the Christian soldier did not fight, does not fight with a sword or armor, but with the weapons that Job used. Job used faith and hope. Christians are, in our metaphorical language, soldiers. So are the angels. That's what St. Luke called them. You remember the Christmas story? We'll be celebrating that before we know it. Talks about the heavenly host. The Christmas story is most literally the army of the skies. They are God's airborne rangers, so to speak, who show up at the 11th hour. The world hangs on the edge of doom to announce a new treaty with God, an armistice, peace, and goodwill. Angels come back in story. We just heard where the Sadducees, wealthy religious traditionalists, come to Jesus. They come with a strange story about a woman that's been married to 7 men in a row. And whose wife will she be in the resurrection, they ask. This is a sort of nitty-picky, misses the point, legalism for which Jesus absolutely had no use. He simply mocks them. You see, the Sadducees didn't believe in the resurrection of the dead. They didn't believe in angels either. So Jesus says, well, in the resurrection, we will all be like angels. Get it, guys? I'm ignoring your nonsense. Basically, it's what Jesus says. And then he moves on to the real point, which is new life. God is the God of the living. He says, so stop worrying about the dead. Stop playing games. Stop troubling yourself about dead people and imaginary people and hypothetical people, and start paying attention to what matters. Loving God. Loving each other. Jesus is a little like Patton slapping a shell-shocked infantryman. He says, "Wake up, soldier. We have a war to fight." But of course, the war we fight with Jesus on our side is not a war with tanks and missiles. It's a war within each soul, where it's always the 11th hour, where every day is a battle for survival. Being a soldier is hard work. That's true of the metaphorical Christian soldier. It's true of the grunt there in the foxhole. It's sometimes paradoxically, they even trade weapons. Sometimes when people are behaving badly, the church needs to become a sergeant, using the law, the rules, as a way to bring people to the gospel of repentance and forgiveness. And sometimes even the toughest soldiers need to break their wartime habits and seek peace. Look at the Army Reserve First Sergeant Seth Castle. He served in many places, Afghanistan, Iraq. He came home to his family in Kansas, came home to his wife and his daughters, but he wasn't the same man that left. We really are after war. His little girls were scared and confused. And so Seth wrote a story for them about a family of lions. The daddy lion, he wrote, loved his family very much, but he had gone away to do some hard work. And he'd come home with fire in his chest, and it kept him awake at night. It made him forget things sometimes and burn a little hotter than it should, and it hurt him. Sometimes because of that fire, the dandelion seems mad at his family, but he still loves them more than anything. The story has been published. It's called Why Is Dad So Mad? We can find it on Amazon. I read a review where another customer, a soldier with PTSD, read this story to his own kids, and they got it. They said, "Daddy, that lion is just like you, but he still loves his family just like you." And as he put the book down, the man was crying long, slow tears. Not every disabled ex-serviceman has lost an arm or a leg. Often the mutilations are invisible to our eyes, things we can't see, but save a place for them anyway, not just in the subway, but in our hearts. Nor can we see by looking at the Christian beside us in our pews, or the stranger on the street, what battles that they have fought in their soul, what wounds they may have suffered, what demons they've defeated, but save a place for them as well, for each other and for the stranger, and even with those who are hardest to love. Remember that the same God has saved us all. The same God has promised to stand with each of us in the 11th hour, in the last battle. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Let us pray. Lord, thank you for holding us fast and never, ever, ever letting us go. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Our closing hymn today, the Battle Hymn of the Republic, is found on 717 in our blue book. Let us stand as you're able, 717. thank you for being here today. Have a wonderful Veterans Day tomorrow and during the day. Remember, while we're celebrating this wonderful special holiday that's helping to guarantee our freedom because of people and their sacrifice. And now go forth in peace, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.
Amen.